Today I'm going to be talking about the new iann Dior album that has been announced, I'm Gone, which is dropping June 5th of 2020, so that will be coming out very soon. Now, I kind of just want to like break down some stuff real quick, but if you guys didn't see, I did drop a Breakfast Club review video. You can go check that out if you want. It's really delayed. That album dropped like in March, and I didn't drop the review until end of May, but at least I got it out there, so... yeah, there's that. I'll probably keep reviewing iann and Stacey's albums as they drop, so I'll probably make a review to I'm Gone when this drops, and hopefully I won't be too delayed with it. But yeah, other than that, I just kind of want to hop on into this video. So people have been asking me to make a video breaking down the I'm Gone tracklist and everything, so that's what we're going to do. Now, something that really disappoints me with this album, when I very first found out about this and I made my original video that did pretty well, talking about this originally being an EP, I was hoping that's what it would be, because the chances, since this is an album, that means the chance of us getting another album this year is very low, because obviously when artists get into record deals, they can drop an album a year and that album gets them, well, depending on the deal, that album will get them one record or one album closer to getting out of their deal. So if this is listed as an album, which at least on Apple Music it is, this will technically be Ian's second album. So whether he signed a 3-album deal or a 5, however many he did, I don't know how good his deal is, or I guess it could be off of anything too. It could be off he has to get a certain amount of streams or something to get out of the deal. Who really knows the specifics, because obviously he also signed with internet money, so with their falling out, we'll probably never know fully on what happened with that, unless iann or poor Stacey actually did like a No Jumper interview and Adam happened to ask him. But anyways, I'm just disappointed that this is an album with 9 songs, and on top of this, 2 of the songs have previously been released, and on top of that, most of these songs are leaked. Okay, that's enough about that. I'm just gonna start breaking down the tracks though. So yeah, like, I would have rather this been an EP, but it is what it is. I mean, I still think it'll probably top Industry Plant, just because I didn't really like that album too much. I mean, I do have some songs on there that I really do like, but overall, I feel like that was just like a guitar style album and stuff, like with the Gunna feature and everything. So I'm honestly more excited for this album than I was Industry Plant, even though a majority of these songs I've at least heard a snippet of, or it's been leaked. But let's just start on in. So Paradise is the first song on this album. This is going to be a great song. It's already leaked. It's like a low quality version of it, but you can find it on YouTube or SoundCloud or anything like that. I know it's leaked. I've heard it. I think it's a good song, and it's probably a good way to start off the project. Another thing that's just kind of weird about this album is like, there's no like story or anything like that with it. It's literally like, it's just like the label wanted him to make a new album, so they threw together all song, like any song that iann Dior had done that could get cleared, and then they're like, okay, we're making it into an album. Like, it was like he had no choice really. I mean, he dropped 2 singles in between his last album, and now he's dropping another album, and there's no, like, this album doesn't really make sense, especially the track listing, because Paradise is like an old iann style, like something you would hear from like Nothing's Ever Good Enough, and then we go to Pretty Girls, which is like a pop song, so it's just kind of weird. And then you have stuff like Sick and Tired on there, which is like rock or punk rock, and then there's Prospect, which is like a fast rap song. Like, it's just a weird mix of songs on such a short album, especially with no like transitions in the album either. It's just song after song. It's just kind of weird. But yeah, the second track on this album is Pretty Girls. This song is leaked. I've listened to it. This is probably gonna be my favorite song on this album, to be honest. I mean, I've heard all these songs besides Sickness, Shameless, and Psycho. I guess depending on what Psycho this is. Obviously, back when iann was known as Olmo, he made a song called Psycho. I highly doubt they're going to use this, or at least if they do, they're going to make the quality and stuff a lot better, because everything about that song was just like low quality. Like, you could tell it was one of his first songs. But yeah, so I mean, besides that, I don't think we've heard these 3 songs, so maybe I'm missing something and those will be really good. But at least from what I've heard from the album, Pretty Girls is going to be my favorite song. So yeah, basically skipping over those 3 songs, because I there's not much known about them. I mean, I'm pretty sure there's like lyrics for Psycho on Genius, but all it says is Psycho was originally released on October 4th, 2017 under iann's old name, Olmo. So like I said, maybe it will be the same song, but also Genius might just be confused because it's technically two songs with the same name by the same artist. So we'll see on June 4th when the album leaks the day before it drops and what it actually is. But anyways, moving on, we have Sick and Tired with MGK and Travis Barker. I actually really like this song. I think the video is awesome. It might be one of Ian's like best music videos there is, but I really like the song, so I think I've already like it's just been out for so long now. I don't know how much I'll actually listen to it when it comes to the album, but we'll see. Runaway Kid is an old leak. This is a fun fact. This song was supposed to be on Nothing's Ever Good Enough. Ian actually previewed this song with Crush My Whip, Pouring, and then, well, back then it was known as I Get High Sometimes. But yeah, all those songs were done at the same time. It was produced by Internet Money. Now, he could have had the beat changed by someone else. I know he works with like Halftime and stuff like that. So obviously a different producer could have remade the beat, but I would definitely say it's probably still Nick Mira or Taz Taylor producing the beat. And I think Runaway Kid is a good song. I mean, I've been listening to the song for so long now that there's no really hype around it for me unless they add a new verse or they change something with it or maybe the beat's different. But one thing I do hope they do with the song is make a music video, because I think you can make a really good music video with this song, especially because the song could like relate to a lot of stuff. This could relate to Ian leaving Internet Money. It could relate to him going to LA, leaving his hometown. I just think there's a lot of cool things. If they really could do a music video for the song, they should. And then moving on, we have Good Day. This song was one of my favorite Ian Dior songs. It's just a good hype song, but then again, it's been out for so long now that there's no hype around it really for me anymore. It's just like, it's a good song. It'll probably be one of the last ones I play on the album. And then we have Prospect. Now, this song I feel like has mixed emotions, like just mixed feelings. Like, I feel like you either like the song or you don't. I think the song is good. I don't like the beat or anything. It's like a Kung Fu Panda song. Like, that is not a joke at all. And then also, I'm not a big fan of Lil Baby, and I don't think he added anything to the song besides making it, like, longer. And yeah, I think this was I think honestly, I would have rather Ian have put out like Runaway Kid or something, like another leak before putting Prospect out, and save Prospect for when the album actually dropped, because then that would just be one newer song we get to hear for the first time when the album dropped. Because not everyone's heard like Runaway Kid and Paradise and Pretty Girls, but I'd rather one of those songs have get dropped before the album than Prospect, because Prospect was one that we didn't even have a snippet for. So, well, besides the one Ian did post on his story, but yeah, so that's the album. If I had to say, I would say my favorite song is going to be Pretty Girls, at least, besides knowing any, I don't know anything from Sickness, Shameless, or Psycho yet, so maybe those will be better, and maybe they changed something with Runaway Kids, so that song will stand out more, too. But I'm definitely excited to see what this album has to bring. I think it's going to be better than Industry Plant. If you haven't seen my Industry Plant review, you can watch it. I think the album's okay. I think Nothing's Ever Good Enough is Ian's best project he's put out since going under Ian Dior. So I hope this, I think this will definitely top Industry Plant, but I don't know about Nothing's Ever Good Enough because that song has no skips on it. All right, guys, thanks for watching the video, and we'll see you next time.